I was told that the hypercube that I made in my previous tutorial isn't actually a hypercube, since it's not rotating. And while I disagree with the notion that transformation over time would be considered an inherent property of a hypercube object, I more so think it's a bit much to expect from a 2-minute video. Or is it? Select the default cube. Add a geometry nodes modifier to it. Add a curve circle with a resolution of 4. Then a curve to mesh node. Then another curve circle with a resolution of 4 as a profile curve, but with a radius of 0.25. Add a set curve tilt node before the curve to mesh node, then a scene time node, and connect the seconds output to the tilt input. That way it animates automatically. Also, add a transform node and set the Z rotation to 45. Alright, let's scale some vectors. Add a set position node, a position node, one vector math node set to scale, and one set to distance. Scale the positions of the vertices by their distance from the scene origin. Take the distance and map it to a new range with from min set to 0.5 and 2 max set to 3.5. Set it as the Z position with the combined XYZ node, and set the X and Y to 0.75, and use this new vector to multiply the scaled positions. Finally, add a transform node and set the scale to 1.3, and the X rotation to 90, and finish it off with a set shade smooth node with shade smooth disabled. For some extra cool factor, add a transform node and a scene time node, and connect the seconds output to the rotation input. Then add a wireframe modifier and set the thickness to 0.1. Hypercube.